choice of cutting tool makes a big difference. I've brought back my little cuticle chart to talk about cutting tools today. Perfect. If you remember in my video on drawing your shears back as you close them, I'll link to it in the description below. I talk about how the shears push the hair in a certain direction. There's a principle in hair cutting, and that is short pushes long. Short pushes long is usually used to illustrate how graduation in a haircut works. The shorter hairs support and push up the longer hairs and make a weight line. But it also matters on a microscopic level. If one side of the hair strand is shorter than the other side of the hair strand, then that hair strand is going to want to push in the direction of the long side. Whether we use clippers, shears, or a razor, it's going to make a difference in the precision of our haircut and in the ease of achieving our finished look. So I have on my hairs here represented four different ends. Can you guess which one represents which of our cutting tools? Let's start right here. This is going to be broken hair. Damaged, broken, maybe a dull shear that's ripping through the hair, or possibly a dull razor with way too much pressure applied. This hair is broken. Clippers, because they move so quick and they're so precise, tend to cut their hair off pretty blunt, very close to shaving. When we cut hair with clippers, it is going to cut it really close from one side of the hair to the other side to even. Cuts the hair off pretty square, which also means that it doesn't give the hair any particular direction to want to push one way or another. So I've seen people cut longer hair with clippers, and they're a really good, efficient tool for especially cutting that super blunt, kind of broomy looking bob, like the Margot Tenenbaum. Clippers are awesome for that because you're going to get a blunt end. The hair is just going to want to sit where it sits and push all the other hairs away from it. No one's really going to want to play together that well. When we cut with our shears, we tend to get a little bit longer on one side versus the other. So that means, let's say we're cutting a angled bob and we want the hair to push toward the face. I'm going to cut toward the face on this side and then flip my hands around and cut towards the face on the other side. Have you ever had a haircut where one side flips this way and the other side flips that way? Sometimes that has to do with the texture of the hair, but that could also have to do with the angle you were holding your shears. Pay attention the next time you see that happen and see if the hair is flipping out on your dominant hand side and flipping under on your non-dominant hand side. If that's the case, it could be your shear direction. That means you need to be cutting towards the face from the back on one side and towards the face from the back on the other side. That leaves us with this long taper here. That's gonna be our razor. Not just good for making hair wispy, but it's also really, really good for giving the hair direction. If I want the hair to lay down, I'm gonna cut with my razor down. If I want the hair to move toward the face, then I'm gonna cut with my razor facing from back to front. We can really manipulate the direction that the hair wants to lay when we're cutting with our razor. And it's the exact opposite of using those clippers. If I want the hair not to play well with others and get a little bit bushy, I might actually choose to cut the hair blunt with clippers. If I want that hair to lay smooth and act like it's all playing well together, then the ultimate expression of that is gonna be with our razor. Something in between that's generally good all around is gonna be our shears. Try to steer away from this one. Ha ha ha.